It's a showdown between prudes and nudes.
Nowadays, it's far too crowded for that sort of caper, and so it is more offensive, I think.
They should have a space like people with dogs have a space.
Queensland police recently making waves by fining at least 15 nuder nudists for willful exposure at the town's unofficial clothes-free beach, Alexandria Bay.
That seems like a bit of a waste of police time to me.
If people are breaking the law, then the police need to be involved.
Police say they've had too many complaints about nudes getting lewd, and now they're cracking down.
We don't condone that nonsense, and we're the first ones to get authorities involved.
Unlike New South Wales and Victoria, there are no legal nudist beaches in the Sunshine State.
It's the perfect weather state. I think there should be some nudity somewhere. Yeah, why not?
In Queensland, yeah, I don't think it's a place for nudist beaches. It's more for families.
But even in places where it's legit to get off your kit, naturists are fighting to continue bearing all on their beaches. Tiagra Beach near Byron Bay and Sunnyside North Beach in Victoria, both the subject of hard-fought battles to keep their nude status, with local authorities worried about X-rated goings-on in the dunes.
We are nudists. It's time for us to be noticed. It's time for us to be recognised because we're not going away.
So do Aussie naturists deserve a place to let it all hang out? Or is buttoned-up modern Australia no place for the clothing optional?
There's plenty of beaches in Australia, so I'm sure they could find one or two or ten that they can happily go and do their thing.
Well, Peter Hopkinson's part of the Roscoe Nudist Community in New South Wales. He joins us now. Peter, thank you so much for getting dressed for the occasion. Peter, sell this to us. What's so great about getting naked in nature?
Well, it's a bit about freedom, I suppose. Not having any worries, not worrying about what people think of you. Enjoy the sunshine, the water and, you know, lifestyle.
Pete, I like your Southern Cross. I'm not really sure about your full moon, though. why do you think so many people are threatened by you guys?
I'm really not sure. I think it probably comes down to a lot of expectations. Religion's played a big part in that, that you shouldn't be doing this, you shouldn't be doing that. So I'm not 100% sure why people are against it.
Peter, according to police, there's some pretty unsavoury stuff going on at these beaches. Can you see in that context why they'd want to act?
Like I'm a local here at New South Wales and our local Birdie Beach, which is a legal nudist beach. Probably the biggest thing is we would like the police to come down there. There are a minority that wreck it for a lot of other people.
Peter, is it becoming harder to be nude in these public spaces? Like, is this making it harder for people like you?
It is. The beaches are a big thing with a lot of people that like to go and sunbake nude, get an all-over tan. Swim in the water is one big thing that a lot of people like to do. And a lot of clubs is where you can be a bit more private in that side of it. And that's why I'm a member of the Roscoe's Club. Also visit a lot of other naturist venues like Twin Falls or Kiata. It's a private venue where you don't get that sort of activity.
I'm interested in the timing of all of this, Peter, because, as you know, it was only a few months ago that Michael Hing got naked, sort of joined the ranks,
yep.
Got naked on television. And it seems to be that since then there's been this, for want of a better word, crackdown on nudism.
The government's trying to keep me clothed,
yeah,
Peter.
Yeah, yeah,
I won't stand for it.
Yeah. Hey, Michael, I'm with you all the way. It's been great to see what you did.
I think you might be the only person who thinks that.
Peter Hopkinson, thanks very much for your time tonight. We really appreciate it.
Not a problem at all. Thank you.
Any excuse to reshow that footage, Hamish?
Yeah. It's the only reason we booked that segment.